with different ingest, so hopefully it
Thank you,
works.
ammo.
What, for my comment?
Yes. Oh, there we go, we're live. Woo!
Hooray,
okay,
it worked.
Now we are live. Sorry, had to switch ingest servers. Also, thank you guys for keeping an eye on that, because otherwise I'd never know.
Yeah, I definitely think original Pocky you should try first if you've never had Pocky before. And my camera is so far behind.
Mine is too, yeah.
Look at that. Literally, I haven't even started saying anything yet on the camera.
It's in slow motion.
Yep, I turned on slow mode for cameras.
Quick catch up in a second.
Gotta save that internet.
Oh, wow.
There we go.
Ammo's sort possessed.
Yeah, this is really bad.
Original Pocky.
If your camera's derping, try turning it off and flipping it back on again, and it should refresh.
It's mostly back to normal now. It's
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Ba ba ba.
Ba ba ba.
Ba ba ba.
Ba da da da.
Are we starting an a cappella marching band? Is that what's happening right now? How much fun would that be, by the way?
I mean, I don't see any of us marching.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not marching.
I'm not
going My feet
to.
Are fucked.
I was in the marching band in high school.
Well, there we go. Now it's the marching a cappella band with just ammo marching.
It's acapella, not a cappella.
Or we could all get segways.
Did you say a cappella?
Segway band.
Like dinosaurs?
An archipelago is not
Does
a dinosaur.
Try to guess
it's a chain of islands.
I play
yeah.
in the marching
Let's,
band.
Why don't we get a chain of islands and be an acapella group?
Was it the French horn?
No.
Was it
well,
the
I
bassoon?
I played three instruments. I had to learn the marching band one a week before starting marching band. They're like, oh, the other instrument you play doesn't have marching band pieces, so learn this instrument in a week. Have fun.
Was it a theremin?
Nope.
Oh.
It was the saxophone.
I want a theremin really bad. Those things look like a lot of fun.
Yeah, and they sound cool.
Yeah, they make spooky sci-fi noises.
But
I like use it while I'm streaming Call of Cthulhu, just...
But I played flute up until I was in school, in which I switched to oboe, and then there was no oboe parts for marching band, so I learned saxophone. Saxophone.
I'm so glad you did that. I was going to look it up.
Alright, so it's been a few weeks, so what do you guys remember from last time?
I got in a fight, and then I got hookers.
We made it
to
the place.
Most important part, there's a fucking water clock.
There is a water clock.
That's really all people need to know about this place. Like, we need to protect the shit out of it. And provide for it. It's got a water clock.
True story.
Morning glory.
We were doomed on the boat. We had impending doom on the boat. And then some cool wizard dude.
With a water clock.
We don't know. It's not his water clock.
Yeah, it is.
Is it his water clock?
Yeah.
Okay, then the cool wizard with the water clock ported us to the town we're in now.
Correct.
And me and
he
Chip
saved us from certain death.
Got with hookers, not at the same time.
Correct.
Yes. And not in real life.
So then everybody went to bed, correct?
Yes. Or at least I know I did.
I don't know how much sleeping I was doing.
Eric, like, well, not you're too much. You're resting between a hooker's thighs.
So take, like, 5 minutes off the long rest for Chip.
Ooh.
Wait, what?
Dang.
Oh. Roll for stamina.
Sure. Scruffles.
I'm just kidding.
roll a constitution save.
Ooh, this will determine how long.
Normal?
Yep.
Yep.
Oops. Constitution.
I don't see ammo in the game.
You're average.
Ammo's usually getting into the game because she's a wiener.
You're painfully average.
She forgets that we used roll 20.
That would have been great. I would have been that one kid in Game of Thrones. What's his name?
That's not necessarily a bad thing.
Podrick Payne.
Podrick was a rock star.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. If I had rolled a 20, I would have been that kid.
Yep, pretty much.
They would have given me back all my money.
You didn't pay for it. Yeah. Right. So, you're good. So, roll a hit die to regain hit points.
Oh, roll it?
Yep.
Right. I forgot. You just don't get it back.
Well, ordinarily, if you were doing a long rest, you would get it all back, but it'll make sense.
You're a jerk.
Why is this not loading?
Oh, wait. So
I'm at zero right now.
Just do this, right?
Yeah, because you got knocked out.
Right, okay. So wait, what's my hit die?
If you look at the very center of your character sheet, it should say a thing there that says hit die.
Oh, 8, so 1d8, or just roll it.
Roll like it like that. Okay. Yep.
There we go. So 4.
And you can roll one of those for each hit die that you have, which is synonymous with your level at this point, basically. So if you're level 2, you get 2 hit die that you can spend to regain hit points. You don't have to roll both of them. You can roll 0, 1, or 2.
Where are we on the map?
Near the...
Kind of in the center.
We're in the Emerald Saloon, or at least I am.
Top right-ish.
Okay, there we go.
And I think Chip's making dust fall down from the ceiling.
No. Not with that 9. You hear the hooker having a conversation with another hooker while it's happening.
And that's talking rude.
About something really mundane.
I didn't roll a 1.
Hey, she is free.
I didn't roll a 1.
If you roll a 1,
and I had 0, I was knocked out. What do you expect me to form like a fucking stallion up there after getting my noodle knocked around? No. Okay.
No, the hooker.
Wait, at which point? Yeah, I was gonna say, whose noodle's getting knocked? Neon noodle.
Noodle head brain is the worst. I hate you so fucking much.
That's not true. It's also
noodles.
Probably just Pax Envy because you didn't go. So, neener.
Whatever. I'm going to have a way better time in San Diego. So
that's not true.
It's true.
I mean, there's ropes of licorice, so probably.
What up, Denises? How's it going, everybody in chat? Thank you very much for coming out and watching. We are just getting started, so fret not. You haven't missed much. So is everybody rolling their hit die? Everybody done rolling their hit die?
Yeah, I'm already full health.
I'm at 4.
And if this is Sherb's fault, I'm not happy about it. Just throwing it out there.
It kind of is.
God damn it, Sherb.
So you guys get about 2 hours of rest, and you hear alarms coming from the front gate the way that you came in.
Yay, I get 5 back.
Out of my trance.
Not going to make you roll to, like, wake up or anything like that because it's loud enough. People are running around. They're like, what the fuck's going on?
I was camping out next to the water clock.
Okay. So, you see a bunch of people running towards the front gate. So we'll start with you, Trip. What do you do? What do
I
now?
I'm interested and go closer to the front gate.
Okay. The gate is open. Guards are at the ready. You see Mila.
Miller,
waiting by the front gate.
Miller.
And the man approaches.
Walk up behind him.
So, open session. What are you guys doing? Orange, you have successfully made it to some kind of safety after being shipwrecked.
Yeah.
Who goes there? State your name, state your business.
Is there a gatekeeper? Like someone?
Yeah, there's two guards basically, like, two standing guards at the ready, like they're not sure what to think of you. Like, they're not outright aggressive, but they are, you know, we're guards.
Yeah.
Our knees are locked.
I just say, I am Bear. I have come for supplies.
Well, you find not many of that around here, I'm afraid. We're a bit low on them ourselves.
I just need shelter for now until I make my way out tomorrow morning.
Hold it right there. How do we know you're human?
I just, like, take my gloves off and show my hands, like...
Best call for the mage. Ship's mage!
Ship's mage!
Ship's mage!
Ship's mage!
I walk over and like, ship's mage!
That's you.
Yeah. As I'm coming down the stairs here, I'm like, that's you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys clearly hear this yelling from the front of the camp. So real quick, before we continue with Trip and Orange, what's everybody back in the Emerald Saloon doing?
Putting on my pants. Like, hopping one leg out of the door. Like, what's going on?
Pants are a smart idea.
Stretching, waking up. My hair was like, my fire hair was like not very much there because I was sleeping, and now that I'm awake, it's like back to normal.
As you stretch, you're like, oh.
Did you not say get bedhead? Is that a thing?
It's like.
So the Commodore comes down from his quarters and loudly exclaims, "Does somebody want to tell me what the fuck is going on in my camp?" We'll go the fuck on then and find out, yeah? Like,
yes, sir.
All right.
I'd stick with Ewok. What's your character's name again?
He's Ucherish. The Commodore is clearly nursing a hangover, so he's more crass than usual.
What was your character's name again, Ewok?
Woody.
Woody. Okay, yes, I would find Woody. I'm like, Woody, what's going on?
I don't have any fucking idea.
Let's go find out. Come on.
Is this God,
you're too chipper.
Siri token?
Yeah, I was going to be like, it's Geralt.
Kind of, yeah. Looks similar. Oh, that was another good cosplay I saw. I saw a really good Siri.
Mm-hmm.
Not the phone one.
Alright, so you guys rush up to the front gate, and you see a man standing there who is... Orange, I'll go ahead and let you describe your character.
Okay, like how in-depth do you want me to go? I don't know.
Yeah, just physical appearance.
Okay, I'm a guy in my late 50s with white hair. Let's see, what was the height? 5'9", somewhere around... I'd say like 175 pounds, so fairly stocky for that size, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
And write that in. And I look lost, like I'm not used to being around humans, even though I don't know. I'm dressed in like outdoors, like I look like I sleep outside type of thing. You know what I mean?
You look like Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, I'm covered in various, kind of like a hodgepodge of animal skins is what I'm wearing.
Gotcha. So
more or less.
Yep.
And I look like I want to come in, but I'm kind of like nervously standing there waiting for someone to tell me what to do almost.
Gotcha.
So I just kind of get in Chip's. Close to Chips and just whisper in his ear, it's best to let the people in the robes and the heavy armor go in the front. We'll just stick back here and see what happens.
We just look at them all like, yes, sir.
So when they're like yelling, ship's mage, I walk up to them and I'm going to be like, okay, I got this. Like, to the guards. And I like, look close, like, examining him. I'm like, don't worry, this won't hurt. And then I go, to his tummy.
Jesus Christ.
Like, holding my staff and just go.
Chip just face palms, like, oh, Jesus
Christ. So, Garrett, what are you doing?
Well, I was going to stay and be Spruce's backup here, but now I'm going to shake my head, smile ruefully, and introduce myself. And I don't remember the name of the camp.
Camp Candlemast.
Camp Candlemast, and I welcome you to Camp Candlemast. Seems like you've survived the same storms that we experienced on our way in.
Welcome to Candlemast, dear.
This is my associate, Spruce Wayne.
Yes, I'm Spruce Wayne. And he's human, by the way. He didn't do anything.
Oh.
I had to... out of the ordinary.
You're just going to confuse everyone.
It's not a normal reaction to
that. Did you cast a...
He's human.
Okay. I get what you did there.
That was the test to see if he was human.
Yep. Garrett, go ahead and roll an investigation with advantage.
Investigation? Okay. While I am scoping Sherb out... Oh, Jesus.
Trip, you can do the same.
Behind Spruce, I'm going to raise my hand up as if to slap him and just kind of put it back down.
Like...
It's a struggle for me to put that back down.
Trip, you're sure that he's a human, and you think he's probably a ranger or some type of, you know, outdoorsy type. Not like, someone you would typically find in a city.
I like lean over to Buckle's character and I go, I think he's trying to be a wood elf.
Sherb, hear that?
As a wood elf.
You guys are standing right there, so.
Yeah, that's what I'm.
Yeah, I sort of hear this, like. Psh, 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 like, I'm just. Like, who are these shifty. I'm just thinking to myself, who are these shifty characters? That makes me distrust this place even further. I don't know if I want to get locked inside. You know, my shifty. Inner dialogue.
I look like a noble. Thank you very much.
Yeah, we're both nobles.
I'm not used to seeing people dress in such fancy clothes.
I'm a wood elf.
So what are you doing, Seraphina, while all this is happening?
Walking over. Can you
and
see
then,
me moving?
And then?
And then I say, hi there. What's your name? Because I wasn't standing there yet. When.
Right.
Yeah. They call me Bear, but usually it's people screaming Bear in the forest.
Oh. Well, are you feeling okay after surviving through what I assume came through the same storm we did? Do you think you need any sort of healing? I am a cleric.
I feel fine. Just a little wet and tired.
Okay. Well, let me know if you do.
And we have a water Orange, clock. You know that in order to reach this camp, you came from the northeast. So you traveled southwest to get to this camp.
Okay. Yeah, I just followed. Yeah. The drought over the last...
I walk over here and I just kind of hang out by the gate.
Wait. Watching the drought over the last few years in the forest has caused me to venture out and gather and get supplies once a year. And now I need to find them elsewhere since the boat didn't work out. more or less.
What coast
are you from? So you're from here.
Eastern coast?
Yes.
So he's not from here then.
Generally speaking, the coast is on the east side of... You're on the eastern edge of the new continent, but for, you know, coasts are irregular, so the ocean from your current viewpoint is to the south. Kind of like a large bay.
Sure.
And you're on the northern side of said large bay.
Yep.
B-A-Y, not B-A-E.
Queen Bay? I was trying to make Vesper play her today. Okay, so if Sherb came from the... Got it. I think Tripp and I had the same thought, like, is he from this place?
Oh, I asked him.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, I was like, so you're from here. Here being Candlemastia.
No. I come from the forest. The Great Forest.
The forest.
Candlemastia is the continent.
Or Garathos. Right, okay. I don't understand geography, history.
I can teach you.
Okay.
But I'd have to, John.
I can just do
things like this, and then I show him my star map.
I'm just interested in surviving.
So, Chip and Woody.
Oh, he didn't care.
Well, yeah, Chip, Woody, and Serafina give me a perception check. Normal roll.
Perception.
Is there any way, like,
I see it.
I'm not looking at anything like that. Like, I'm looking at this table in front of me. Like, I'm trying to...
Yeah, it's just to notice something. So, go ahead and roll it.
Perception.
Footage of a D&D character.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're wrapped up in whatever it is that you're looking at. Chip, likewise. But ammo, you definitely notice there's, like, on this wall right here, just above these barrels, there's, like a ramshackle type of, not really even peephole, but you know, like, how older doors, like, sometimes they'll have that little panel where you can just slide it open and see out? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So you see, like, something like that quickly opens up, and you see, like, a pair of eyes just, like, glare back and forth of, like, what the fuck is going on out there? And quickly slam shut. And you hear, like,
is this Doctor Who? Is this an alternate dimension?
No.
Is that fucking farting guy? That
show. So yeah, that's all.
I tell them we should probably get back in the camp before
I'm inside.
I just ask, are we trading for my lodging tonight, or
what's going on? Leave that up to the Commodore. He runs his camp.
Okay.
And he's going to want to meet you.
It's just not safe out here.
I can take care of myself.
Well, you say that.
Yeah, but have you seen a water clock? Did you know water could tell time?
So the guards agree. They're like, hey, we've got to get these doors shut. Everybody in.
Okay. I need to get used to what everyone's token looks like.
Can I, like, lean over to Woody and be like, what are we looking at?
Just keep an eye out on keep an eye out, Greeny. Come on.
Alright.
Over here's the water clock. It's accurate to half an hour of the time.
You know what, Greeny? That fucking device on the ground over there. Go ask questions about it.
Is the water clock like...
Wow. This?
Did it sprung a leak?
Yeah, go!
Nope, yeah. It's just telling the time.
What time does it say it is?
What? I'm going... I like Slidle. Who is this dude?
That is Oros, the man who rescued you, remember?
Oh, okay, the mage dude.
Yes.
I like walk up and I'm like, hey, so this water clock, how does it work?
With magic, and he boops you on the nose.
I like this guy.
but how?
Magic.
He leans in like really close, like super uncomfortably close, and his eyes get really wide, and he just says, "What know ye about the weave?"
Nothing. I don't know anything.
Then my time cannot be wasted. And he immediately goes back to his experiments.
I like look back at Woody, and I'm just like, follow him.
Is there anything on this table? Like, I just
want. There's lots of things.
All right, what do I need to roll?
You trying to steal something?
I want to steal something good.
Okay, roll sleight of hand.
Come on, baby.
Nice.
Okay. Now roll d10. Okay. Now make a constitution save.
Uh-oh.
Okay. You have turned into a female version of yourself. You grabbed a particular gem off the table, and that's what its effect was.
Do we notice this?
For the follow.
Can I roll
yeah, it's obvious. Like, it's like, oh. Boop, 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 boop.
Jip.
I come over and I'm like,
run over and I'm like,
away from you, and I like knock it out of his hand with my staff.
Like, I cover a drop that. I cover a laugh with a cough. I'm like,
what do you have boobs?
I'd fuck me.
And Oros maybe pays no attention to first. Like he doesn't seem to care. He's too wrapped up in his experiment.
Can I, like, put that in a cloth or something, or does it still turn me into...
Nope, the effect persists.
For how long?
Can I do an arcana check?
Yeah.
Maybe one of the other ones turns you back.
Like, check this, see what this does. What is this?
Don't touch that.
Trip, you know that the effect will be in place until a remove curse is done.
You've also been cursed.
Know that generally it's a bad idea to try and steal from mages. For this reason.
See, we mages are tricksy. We put the shiny things that put curses on people outside so you touch them. And then they do stuff like this. I'm surprised he didn't turn you into a newt.
But this is magnificent. I need it.
Chip just starts laughing. He's like on the floor like, you're a fucking girl.
I, like, whisper to Woody, touch him with the gem.
I'm going to touch Chip with the gem.
Oh, goddammit! Oh, I don't think I would notice, because I'd be too busy laughing and be like, oh my god, you have boobs! Look at your boobs!
So how are you touching her with the, or rather him, sorry, with the gem?
Hey, Chip, catch.
Just like, yeah. Chip, catch. Like, here you go. Just toss it.
Are you catching it, Chip?
I would probably do it just reflex. I don't know, like, what... I feel like there should be, like, a role of, like, I remember not to touch the gem, or I just, like, reflexively catch it. Because it's just like, oh, something's coming at my face, catch it.
It could be, like, a ranged attack. Like,
make a wisdom save.
You, like, move your
I think I'd probably just catch
it. Hits you.
We'll do a wisdom save. Okay, so you definitely catch it. So it lands in your hand, and it feels very cool, and nothing happens.
It must have been a one-use thing.
Like, touch it, and I, like, hold it up, and I'm like, nah.
And then you
put it in your
it
pocket, Chip.
It.
It's going with us.
I put it in my pocket.
Chip, roll nature.
Nature. Kitty.
Normal roll. You're pretty sure it's just glass.
Oh, okay. I just, like, toss it back to Woody's, like,
this is
useless now.
So is it,
but
like,
hey,
really pretty?
This is a pirate dream right now. Just imagine like... how much shit I can get with this. I gotta work on the voice, though.
What's a rough pirate lady's voice?
Yeah, I'm going to keep it. I'm going to put it in my pocket.
It's a memento.
Of his lost penis.
Oh, God.
Chip would lean in and be like, did everything change?
The transformation is utter and entire. I'll just put it that way.
You have to have periods now.
Oh. Do elf ladies have periods?
Yeah, probably.
Probably.
Once every 20 years, I'm sure.
So down to the chromosomal level, he is now a lady.
Imagine what happens after 20 years of buildup.
Yep. 20 years. And Trip, you know, it was. You're sure it was some kind of transmutation magic.
It's like the elevator in.
Chip's just like the Woody. Buckles, how you doing?
Just start touching all the gems.
Chip, I'm tempted.
Keep your eyes
really
on the
tempted.
Ground. Let's go.
Like yes, sir. I mean, ma'am, sir. Ma'am, sir.
Our first transgender.
Can I hit? I want to roll. just backhand.
Totally.
Not like the hard, peanuts. But just like, shut the fuck up. What would I roll for that?
One more time? What is it?
I just want to like.
He's just trying to backhand me.
Yeah, just backhand.
Oh, just unarmed strike then.
Melee.
So, it'll be d20 plus whatever your proficiency bonus is plus strength.
I like turn around and look at Orange's character and I'm like, you know what I said? It's safer inside. Don't touch this stuff.
I didn't plan.
Yeah, you missed.
Yeah.
Strange.
God, being a woman's throwing off my aim. Let's go.
You're not
you gotta
used
get
to
used
compensating
to the boobs.
For the D's. Alright. So, everybody stop.
Woody, we're gonna have to get you a bra.
I will shove my fist up your ass, Greenie.
I need
could probably make you
perception checks from Garrett, Serafina, and Bear. And Bear, I will give you advantage on your perception check.
Okay.
I see it.
You don't know that.
Yeah, I do.
Mm-mm.
Oh, wait a minute.
Well, if it's 20 DC, or like 25 DC.
If the skill isn't checked, you can't roll it?
No, you can. You can roll any of the skills. Anybody can roll any skill.
The checked ones are just the ones that you can, like, get ranks.
Oh,
in.
It's because I have a pop-out.
Yeah, it's the ones you provide. The checked ones are the ones that you apply your proficiency bonus to because you're proficient in those skills.
Great, okay.
Okay, so you all notice that... So, on the other side of the north wall... There's a bit more beach and then trees, and you see the trees are starting to shake and move in an unnatural way. Yeah, birds are flying away.
Like a dinosaur's coming?
Hard to say, because it's nighttime, so you're only seeing like the silhouette of the trees, kind of like you just know that it's not the wind causing them to move.
God damn it, we're on the island from Lost.
Lost
Still
World.
Have not seen that show.
Yeah, I haven't seen it either. I just know there's a vault with a code, and it's in WoW.
Yeah, if we find a hatch, I'm
and it ended, and everyone was just kind of salty about it.
It was bad.
Yeah, there's a reason. This is before Netflix and on demand. I watched every episode of that fucking show every week.
Mm-hmm. And at the end, the producers just came to your house and punched you in the nuts.
Yes.
Well, not yours, because they're gone now.
Yeah.
When suddenly...
an ugly-looking wood elf lady or a pretty one?
That doesn't matter right now, Trip, because you're going to roll initiatives.
Oh, I was going to ask.
No? What? Fighting?
People have seen this stuff. I probably didn't see it, though.
Trip was too busy looking at Woody's boobs. How big are they, by the way?
D's. That's what I said.
Oh, okay. Wow.
I bet they're a nice full D. Are we all rolling? Do you have a script now?
If that's the case.
Yeah, you should see the turn order up, so go ahead and roll them.
Oh, we roll them up.
Yep.
Why do I always get a 5?
Initiatives.
Always.
Oh.
So oh, you orange, never get to roll initiative with advantage? Okay.
The way you do this is it's right from your character sheet. Just make sure you have your token selected and hit the initiative text on your character sheet. It should be right near the top.
Okay. Oops, I messed up. I didn't have my thing selected.
Oh, so if Ewok has...
Can mine be a 16 instead of a 4?
Yes.
Then Seraphina is like...
just disappointed, like, comparison. Like, no. Aww.
Help me out here. Is it on the right or left side? Oh, there it is. I see it.
Yeah,
sorry,
it's
got
top
it,
middle.
Got it. Got it.
Yep, you got it. Perfect.
Damn.
Alright, so Bear, you are first. First thing that happens is horn blows from the guards on the northern watchtowers. Movement in the trees!
Okay.
Movement in the trees!
Wait, so which
I like
side
echo things.
Is the movement coming from?
North.
Which direction?
North.
Yeah. North is always north.
I mean, do we hear any animal noises or
well, you,
anything?
You hear the birds, you know, panicking and flying off.
I mean, can I, let's see, can I roll, can I do a nature roll to try to figure out what that would signify, like?
Big.
Sure. Scary. You can. It's just going to be limited by your line of sight. So you're
right.
You're trying to determine this based off the movement of the tops of the trees that you can see, basically. So go ahead, but with disadvantage, because you can't really see.
Okay.
It's a Snarf 11.
Based on how the trees are moving, you don't necessarily think it's one big thing so much as it's lots of not-so-big things.
And just look at everyone. Prepare yourselves. It's more than one. That's all I know from my experience. And I guess I'm gonna like wait for everyone, see if anyone's moving inside. Like, are we going inside? what are we doing?
No, that's fine. You can delay.
I feel very.
It's all so sudden.
Yeah. I feel like I want to run out into the trees and I'm just not comfortable behind the walls.
Gotcha.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, Seraphina.
I'm just gonna be like, "What the fuck's going on?" Because I don't know what's
going on. So you're
delaying? Yes.
All right, okay. Chip.
I would probably run up to Seraphina and be like, "I'm not ready for a fight. Help me!" And, like, point at my boo-boos, like, ow.
Yeah, she's still a bit lumped up from her fight. Like, anime style,
it.
Like, she's just got, like, one eye is just, like, huge and swollen. Got, like, the fat lip. Help me, babe!
Before I run up to Seraphina, though, I, like, put a hand out to Woody and be like, "You stay back, ma'am." And then I run up to Seraphina.
Wow.
God damn it.
Maybe accidentally do a boob graze.
Wow. Roll slide hand.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Well, it's supposed to be accidental.
You just run by and just...
if this were in the real world, you would probably be going to county for that. Not accidental at all, boob grab.
Scruffles, you need consent to grab ladies' boobs.
It's true.
Really? No idea.
So Seraphina, would you like to take your delay to help out Chippy?
Sure. I guess.
She's so stingy with heal spells.
I only get 2. In a day.
Is there no instantaneous cast in 5e?
You only get 2 spells?
I don't get a cantrip that heals, only first level spells.
Yep.
And I only get two. Instead?
Are you sure you only get two? What level are you?
One.
Level one.
Oh, that's right.
So I only get two.
We totally forgot to do experience from last time.
Oh yeah, we did.
Are we supposed to be two?
Too late.
Yeah,
now.
We're supposed to level, I think.
Well, we only have 200 experience, so. We're supposed to level from Trip's game on Monday.
Is it 200 experience to level 2?
It's 300.
300.
300.
So what are you guys at
50
now?
Out of 300.
205.
How are you at 200?
You missed a session, remember?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, right.
Yeah, that's what you get, Wiener. Two first level spells.
So what's everybody else at?
I am not aware of the cantrip.
205.
250.
Okay, you guys wouldn't have leveled from last time anyway.
Damn.
Yeah, I'm not aware of any cantrip that heals, so I can only use spell slots, and I only have two. So, gotta use them sparingly. What's your
like
health?
Gauze.
4 out of 9.
You only get a drop of sand.
Yes. Alright, so... Where is it? Where is it? Cure wounds, okay.
Also, all the spells and everything like that are in the built-in compendium.
You get 8.
Nice. Full health.
Hooray!
Oops.
Okay, I only get one more.
What's your...
sparingly.
What's your wisdom modifier, Emma?
3.
You should have more spells than 2. Significantly more spells than 2.
2 first level slots is what it says. And I can know...
I'm sure you guys can.
There's no limit on the spells that you know. You can... You're... You don't have spells known like other classes. You're...
Well, prepared spells,
right.
I get.
You can prepare any spell on the cleric list that you can... Yeah, exactly.
Is different.
But no, she doesn't get bonus spells for high wisdom. That's 3.5.
Yeah, it's spell slots.
I was just reading a thing. Yeah, well, it's spell slots now instead of spells now.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't ever remember reading anything about getting bonus spell slots for high wisdom.
Okay, I am wrong then.
I get 2 first level spell slots at level 1, and I can know 3 cantrips. But none of the cantrips that I'm aware of are healing cantrips.
Fair enough.
So only get one.
Yeah, you don't get extra spell slots for high wisdom, but you do get extra prepared spells. Is that what you were talking about?
Well, prepared spells is a spell slot.
You prepare the list of cleric spells that are available for you to cast, choosing from the cleric spell list. When you do so, choose a number of cleric spells equal to your wisdom modifier plus your cleric level.
That's what I was just reading.
So yeah. You should have a total of 4 prepared.
Exactly.
Yep, but I can
she can only cast 2.
Gotcha.
See how
okay,
that
that's the difference, yeah.
It's a little, it takes a little getting used to when you're used to 3.5. I had a little trouble with that as well.
It's kind of like how with sorcerers in
That's...
You can cast whichever ones you want, but you can only cast a certain number of them.
Right.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Yep.
It works like that.
All right, Spruce Wayne is next.
I wait for milady. I'm going to protect her. Yes.
Okay. Woody is next. Girl named Woody.
It's Woodette now. Thank you.
Woodette.
I'm going to run up over here where all the commotion is, where everyone's gathered up. I'm going to push Spruce out of the way. Call him a pig.
I'm not staring at your boobs.
I don't know that.
Can I, 5 foot out of the way as a reaction?
Sure. Doing anything else?
I just want to keep the pretty lady safe.
And just, that's it. Just ready.
Okay. Garrett Reeves?
I'm going to face the north here for where the threat's coming from, grab my holy symbol, and lay on hands myself up to full health.
Nice.
Because fuck that.
Alright. That was everybody?
Yes.
Guard tower shout, they're coming!
This is gonna suck.
So now I have work to do, so please hold. Out of my way, stupid token thing. Dumb token thing. Jesus. Thank you, Benzheim, for that $5 holla. The air horn returns. Thank you very much, sir. Also good to know that my my alerts are actually working this time. So you start moving towards the northern gate, and...
This is where the northern gate is punched in, isn't it?
Well, you definitely hear something hit the outside of it, like lots of somethings, just... And the gate's starting to buckle, and like, you know, dust basically flies from the impact of it. And, like, even the two guards standing at the gate are like, ah! And take, a 5-foot step back. How they know to avoid the spikes this time?
Oh, boy.
Alright. There you are first.
So, how high are the walls?
20 feet.
20 feet? And, okay. Oof. Okay, well, I'm going to get myself in position to... So I have a longbow with some arrows. So I'm going to move... Let's see if I can move. I'll place myself kind of like right there. Here. And, I don't know. I draw my bow.
Okay. On 20, these two come rushing out of the Emerald Saloon and prepare for combat. Haystack says, "Alright boys, don't shit your knickers now. We've beat these devils back before, we know what we're doing." And the guards, like, immediately kinda gain control of themselves, like, almost like they're more afraid of him than what's on the other side of that gate. Definitely in charge of the men. So, Seraphina, you are next.
One second, my page is loading very slowly. I'm gonna move towards this way a little bit. If I could click on the thing. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna stop there for now until I can see whatever it is that's trying to get through.
Okay. Chippee!
How far can I dash?
Dash is double move.
So I could move 80 feet in a dash?
Yes, if your movement is 40.
Hot damn. Okay.
Whoa.
I think I'll, maybe I should get a bit closer unless I come in. And I can't be obstructed, right? Like, I can't move through Seraphina or around her, whatever.
It's just, it counts as difficult terrain if you're moving through a friendly space. So that, instead of 5 feet, that's 10 feet.
Difficult terrain does not cost extra movement because of my mobile feet.
Then there you have it.
Cool. Just trying to think if I should just delay. I'll just delay. I'll wait until I see them.
Okay. I'm gonna Swain.
Run at them and punch. One punch.
I'm going to move here.
And?
I was just moving.
Okay. That it?
Yes.
Alright, Woody. Woodette, sorry. You might want to change the the name. I'll keep saying that otherwise.
I'm just gonna keep holding, waiting.
Okay. And Garrett Reeves?
I'm moving on up with those other guys from the Commodore.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna do the very pedantic
hold!
and that was a double move for me, so okay. That's all I got.
Alright. I got some rolls to make. Let's see. Assist. So. And strength. Alright, so you see these huge black scaled, they look like lizard folk to you, but not quite. More akin to crocodiles. And definitely bigger. Also, they don't seem to be wielding any kind of weapons, and they're just smashing through this wood, like, with their sharp claws. So, they've created a few holes in the gate. Garrett, roll an intelligence save. With advantage. Yeah, so you can just do another normal roll. Yeah. So you know that gate's not gonna hold. Like, basically, probably next round they're coming through that gate.
Okay, I'm gonna shout the two men in front to step back, and the guys behind me to prepare for a charge.
Okay. So they will definitely take your advice. We're going to move here and here. Oops. And we are back up to Bear. So yeah, you see these huge, like...
Oh.
What?
Can I take my delay then? I think I might just move a little bit closer.
Yes.
Since...
If you're taking your delay, do it now.
Okay, I'll just... Image it. I think... Right. Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, you see these large, you know, basically looks a lot like Killer Croc from the Batman game, but there's lots of them. And their faces are a bit longer, like I said, almost like a crocodile.
Can I see through the gate from where I'm standing?
Well, you can see they've made holes in it, yeah.
Okay. I just yell, "What are they and how many?"
I don't know, and I don't know.
All right. I just look around and make sure everyone has a weapon. Kind of like most people look like they're ready. Everyone that's outside here, I hope. What about you, blacksmith? Like this blacksmith guy, he's just kind of standing there.
So another cool thing that you can do in 5th edition that I like players to do is if there's like if you're taking a delay, if there's a set of circumstances that would take you off delay, just let me know what that is. Like, if the for example, if the goblin runs over to that lever that I know triggers a trap, I'm going to shoot him. You know what I mean? So that way, you know, it triggers your reaction basically when he starts moving towards that. So it's like, if, you know, as soon as the gate breaks down, I'm going to fire a shot. Just let me know that in advance. All right. So that was Bear, Seraphina.
Can I ready myself to use Sacred Flame as soon as I see something break through the gate?
Well, you can see them now. They're making holes in the gate like this big.
Okay. I didn't know that I'd be able to do that if they hadn't fully come through yet.
You don't have to see the whole target.
I'm gonna have to aim at them. Hang on, let me actually see. I don't think this spell needs a roll to attack. So, let's see. Nope. Oh, you just have to do a dex save.
Okay, well first roll d4, yeah. So I know which one you're targeting.
Okay.
And now for the dex save.
Which you have to roll a 13 or higher.
Immune.
Aww. God damn it!
So I'm actually going to mark that one. Come on. I'm going to mark him red. There we go. Alright. But not so bad, because it's just a cantrip. You know what I mean? So... it sucks less when you miss with a caster in 5th edition. What are you doing, Chippy?
Can I punch through the wall at them? Sure. Oh wait, there's one right there, so I can get a good shot at him.
You could try.
Look at that, he's within range. Cute. So yeah. I like haul ass. Do you like the anime one with my arms out behind me?
Well, keep in mind, if you're dashing, you can't attack.
What?
You can't attack if you're dashing.
What do you mean?
You can only do that if you're charging and you don't have line to charge, because you'd have to charge through Garret Reeves.
You make a melee attack against a creature you... Oh, I thought that I could dash, hit, and then dash away. That's what mobile did.
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah.
Let me just look that feed up real quick. I think it allows you to do that, because we were talking about that last night.
Can't remember.
But I just want to double check.
I thought that was the
I'm
point.
Sorry. I broke it.
You broke it. Hey, but you're in sync now.
I broke it.
Dang Jinx it, Emma.
Broke it.
Okay.
Yeah, because we were talking about it last time, and that's why I put run up, hit, run away. In little like brackets.
No, it's when you make a melee attack against a creature, you don't provoke opportunity attacks from that creature for the rest of the turn, whether you hit or not. That has nothing to do with your dash action.
Oh.
The
so I can't
the
run other, up, hit him, and then run away?
The two are mutually exclusive. Because it says when you use the dash action, difficult terrain doesn't cost you extra movement on that turn. But you can't dash and attack in the same round. Unless you have another class ability that allows you to do so. Or,
fuck, no, that was the whole thing that I was excited about. I get to hit them and then run away.
You can do that, you just can't double move, hit them, and then run away.
Oh, okay.
Because dash and attack are two separate actions.
Okay. Okay. Then I move here.
And Dundare?
And that's it.
Okay, Spruce Wayne.
Delay.
Okay. Woody? Et?
I'm just gonna sigh, and I'm gonna double move to go over there and help Chip.
I follow suit.
I've grown fond.
Does Chip make your lady bits tingle?
Ooh.
Do they actually tingle? I've never asked.
Depends on the motion of the ocean, buddy.
I guess, right? I mean, I'm just curious what's actually tingling.
Michael, you just wait till we get back to the Undermountain. See what's going to happen. See what's going to happen.
All right, and Garrett Reeves?
Yeah, I've now got a full-on ready-to-action crouch down, got my shield up. Anything that's coming through this gate, I'm smashing it in the face.
Okay. My turn.
I took my delay to follow Ewok's character.
Okay.
I don't know if Tucky's talking about the books or lady parts tingling. Let's find out.
Okay. That's one.
What the hell?
Two. Three. Okay.
Are they all attacking with advantage?
They're breaking down the gate with advantage.
Oh.
Because they got buddies. And buddies give you advantage.
They sure do. And thank you very much for that follow. Why won't it let me grab you? There it is. Now you can see. As the gate comes crumbling down, like, they literally, like, just about tore it off the hinges.
Jesus, fuck.
So...
Oh, that's a lot of dudes.
I just, as soon as I see those, I kind of just grab them, Chip, and like, I think we better back up.
15, 20. Yeah, these guys are all charging.
Oh, fuck.
Charge. Charge. Charge and charge.
We'll be seeing you later, Buckle.
What the fuck? Why is there gigantic one?
I'd like to use my delay, please.
Yes.
Thank you.
I like the look of uncertainty. Like, please?
I really want to hit that guy in the face.
Go for it, man.
Please, oh please, oh please. Come on, natural armor.
You're striking with advantage because they're charging.
Yes! Oh.
But please hold.
Come on, I have this heroic thing. I got these guys arrayed at me in a fan.
This makes me think... Like, I see this and I remember back to that statue.
Shut up about that. I could have taken it.
Alright. So, that's a miss.
Thank you. Yeah. I'm getting my shit pushed in.
And they just get right in your face and set right into you with some bite attacks.
This is 3.5, so
first
attack
one,
of opportunity.
First Buck one off. Hits a 13.
Doesn't hurt. It's shit.
And second one?
Nope.
It's a 17.
Nope. Oh! Yep.
17 hits?
Yeah.
Okay. So the second guy got you with a bite?
Ah, fucker. I bet he's bite my flailing attack arm. I just start hitting him. Shit!
For 6 damage.
Jesus, I'm glad I fucking used Lay on Hands. Holy shit.
Goes right at you. Alright, next one is attacking the guard.
This is gonna take a while.
It's the guard.
Usually when 7
damage,
this many.
Guard is dead.
Oh my god.
Whoa.
They're,
wait,
just
dead?
Like,
they're all dead.
They're just like commoners, basically.
But still,
but
like,
they fought these things
right?
before.
They like have. A... There's less of them now than there were before.
It's like a D&D mall cop or what? Like, he's just his little main badge.
Right. And other guard. Oh,
whoa.
Yeah. And dead. This guy over here just gets his fucking head completely bitten off. And you see the lizard foot, like, clamps down, like, over the top of his head, just rips his head off and swallows it whole.
Chip, like, recoils, like,
you can see the large, like, lump move down its fucking throat sac and just...
That's gonna be a hell of a dump later.
Helmet and everything.
Oh, Jesus.
Wow.
That's so he gone.
I wish I was my dragonborn. I would spit
and...
<those
guys>. And, let's see. I'll do bear first.
I was wondering... Because my favorite enemies are beasts, would these be classed as beasts?
Nope.
Nope, okay. Still, could I do a intelligence roll to see if I know anything about them, like where their weak points are?
Sure. Roll nature with advantage.
Nature with advantage, okay.
The eyes and dick.
They look like humanoid crocodiles to you, so you would assume that they would have hard armor, probably pretty much covering their whole body. So, not really any weak points per se, but they're also not very intelligent.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just wondering, like, thinking to myself, where am I going to aim on these? It seems like my arrows aren't even going to pierce their armor. So can I do an attack too, or
oh yeah, that? Absolutely.
Okay. I'm just gonna aim for this guy. And first attack, let's see. So that's just a normal roll for the attack?
Yes.
Okay. Oh what, sorry, wrong thing, dang it.
It's the same bonus, so that's fine.
Oh, okay.
So just roll the different damage if the damage is different, which it should be. I think longbow is D8.
Yeah, so if I click on that, let's see if I did that right.
That yeah, work? Now you can just click the longbow damage in the, the roll box. That's fine.
Okay.
And which one were you aiming at? Just ping him?
The second one from the left.
That guy?
Yeah.
Okay. You hit. And you sunk an arrow right into his chest. Dude. And it doesn't seem to take any notice besides hissing. Like a deep, guttural, crocodile-type hiss of like, I can't even do it. Because they get that deep fucking death metal gurgle. So, good job, you just shot George Corpse Grinder with an arrow.
Damn.
And that's 8 damage, okay, on him. Good hit. Seraphina is next.
I am gonna... Hang on. Let's see. How far am I through that one? I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Ooh, close. Okay. Let's see... Moment, please. Aw, he's too far. We have to move closer. Why?
No, it's George. The singer from Cannibal Corpse.
There we go. Okay. 60 feet is the range.
He doesn't like gnomes.
Okay. Hang on. I gotta get closer. There. Now I should be in range. Yeah, I'm gonna hit the big one with Sacred Flame.
Oh, are you?
Try to, yeah.
Ooh, full damage.
It's 1d8, so I don't know. Does my.
Just takes 8 damage? Modifier,
my wisdom modifier doesn't go with that, does it? Okay. 8.
Okay.
Radiant damage.
8 on the big one. Heard.
And also, I think it makes it so that the next attack on it is...
Made with advantage.
Made with advantage, I think.
If made before the beginning of your next turn.
Yes.
Alright, Chip is next.
I poke this one.
And by poke, you mean punch?
Yes. No, just my one finger. Right in the eyeball.
Three Stooges style?
You've got advantage now.
I get advantage, yeah?
No. Normal roll.
What? Why don't I? But he's standing right next to me.
It's a melee combat with Buckle.
Yeah.
Fuck! Should I reroll that?
Right, but the way I would do that is mob versus mob is it just cancels each other out.
Oh. Should I reroll?
Or we could all have advantage. It's up to you.
You want me to reroll?
Well, no, we'll just do it that way. So that's fine. That's it.
Okay.
Which one were you hitting? The one in front of Garrett or the one?
The one in front of me.
Okay.
The one that got hit with the arrow. Yeah. How do I do? Oh yeah, right.
3 damage heard.
And then I move back.
Punch it in the jaw. Good job.
Yay.
Loving that mobility now.
Shouldn't
mm-hmm.
that attacker?
But you forgot something. It's only that creature that doesn't get opportunity attacks.
Oh, fuck! Fuck! I didn't know it was only that creature!
You gotta know your abilities, buddy.
From that creature. It says it right there. Shit.
Actually, they'll try at you with the claws. So, first one is definitely a hit.
They both hit.
Second one, 15. Hit. Okay. Four and five.
I'm at zero.
You're unconscious then. So put your character right here.
Where?
Oh, zero's unconscious in five?
Yeah, zero is unconscious.
That was just bobbleheaded. Or was that just 3.5?
I thought they got one action a turn. Nice. She's fucked.
No, zero is unconscious.
Fuck, I forgot! I forgot the thing.
There's different conditions that do that in 5th edition.
Oh, I was looking at the wrong spell. It's actually the Guiding Bolt that does that. The,
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Advantage thing. I was looking at the wrong one. My bad. But I did the damage correctly.
Okay. So... allow the big boys to handle business. Actually, this one's going to cover this one. So I'll do him first. Attacking with a long sword. And hit. Hold on. I just got to make sure I have the right damage for longsword. I think it's 1d8, but...
Scruffles, is your character a female?
No.
It's male? Okay.
Yeah, we've got all kinds of gender benders going on now.
I just want to make sure.
Yes, 1d8 slashing.
Because I was thinking of saying something on my next turn, I was like, wait, he or she? And I was like, if I get it wrong, it's awkward.
And he got 7 damage in, and the other guy, same thing. I'll just roll this twice, that's fine. It's a hit anyway, so... Six damage on this one, dies. And additionally... I have a present for Garrett. I got a present for Garrett.
He doesn't want it.
Oh, he definitely wants this.
What is it? Can I not be killed?
We're level 1, it's okay if you die.
I know, but I like this character.
No, but if you die, you're level 1, it just comes back.
Once within the next 10 minutes, you can roll a d6 and add that number to any one ability check, attack roll, or saving throw you make. You have been granted bardic inspiration by the man with the loot, none other than Kip Stinger.
Kip Stinger.
Bards don't suck!
Right?
How often do you get that?
It's only once, and he has to use it with sometime within 10 minutes.
Aw. Better than nothing.
It's a lot better than nothing, and it's a lot better than bards used to
be. Plus one.
He saw you were in trouble, he saw you got hit, so he ran over, and he's providing you some bardic inspiration. You know, he's singing a love ballad to Tyr. I want to know what Tyr is! I want you to show me.
What'd you say his name was?
I'm gonna show him.
Kip Stinger.
I'm pretty sure that's a pun on some.
Trips only 17. 17.
Not 17.
On the edge. Of 17?
It's a song.
I know.
No, you don't. Because that came out when I was like 5.
We know what old music is.
It's not old music. Oh, no. Sure. I listen to the classics. God damn it.
Old in music years is older than 10 years.
Old in music years is like 6 months ago.
What? Right. It's Bruce Wayne, what are you doing?
I'm casting Grease there.
Just like an old computer.
Which
is
four squares?
Like 3 or 4 years ago.
Draw me a rectangle.
I don't like Grease in this. It's weird shaped.
It's not. It's the same as it ever was.
No, Grease is bigger.
It's 10-foot square. It's always been a 10-foot square, trust me. I have used it with every caster I've ever had that can cast Grease. It's always been a 10-foot square. Okay, and those four squares? Gotcha.
Crowd control.
Good job. Woody?
Oh, I think that guy has to make a dexterity save.
Not if he's not in it.
That guy?
Yeah, he's not in one of those four squares. If you want it in those four squares, then you have to center it here. See what I'm saying?
On my...
Is this a situation where it looks like it's in the right spot on your screen, but not on
mine? I think so.
Okay, now it looks right. Weird. Alright, that's my bad. So, hold on. Let me move that real quick. Why isn't letting me grab that? There we go. There, just so it's correct on my screen, so I know.
Yeah.
Okay, so I actually need to make two dexterity saves. And I'll do these with advantage, because they're kind of still in the process of breaking down the thing, so... What do I need to get?
13.
That is a fail. And that is a fail. Critical fail. So they're both knock prone.
Yay!
And, this guy took 2 damage. He fucking ate shit.
Did he, like, fall on one of the spikes?
I fell on my keys! So, good spell trip.
Thank you.
So, now
can't
for Woody.
Clap for yourself, Trip. Put it down.
I'm clapping for Spruce.
I'm gonna yell at the wizard in the back and be like, "Hey, Fizzle, you gonna come up here and help?"
Boop. No.
You're muted, Trip. Trip.
Oh.
But it was
I'm
so
sure it
funny.
Was really funny.
Alright, is that all you're doing?
No, I'm gonna fire a chuck an arrow at Dissin.
Okay.
Dissin Human. Oh, where's my shit? Oh, there it is. Someone got that.
Hit. 7 heard. Nice hit. And Garrett Reeves.
I'm gonna call back to Serafina. If you've got Sacred Flame, put it on that grease right now. And then I'm gonna use my mighty +6 on this dude right in front of me.
It's radiant, not fire.
Yeah, it's not actually fire.
It's just called Sacred Flame.
Just grab your hair.
But I have the produce flame cantrip, so...
You guys exhaust me.
So what are you doing, Garrett?
Jesus. I'm using my +6 anyway. Please let that be a hit.
Roll your d6.
I thought I get +6 too.
No, you get to add a d6 to your d20 roll.
I misunderstood.
So you can hold off if you want. You only have to use it within 10 minutes, which is plenty of time.
Yeah, I'm going to hold it.
Okay.
And I'm going to... Yep. Mm-hmm. I'll just position myself a little bit so I'll give him more cover to Chip since he's down.
Gotcha.
Incomplete.
Alright. We've got more company. Alright, so those two are going to attempt to stand up. Yes, and yes. And I'll do these two first.
I just wanted to punch things. I got knocked down.
Charging.
But you get up again. They're never going to keep you down. Come on, you like that one.
Gonna I make... used to love that song.
Gonna make another dex save.
When I was like 10.
And pass. And Garrett, give me a perception check.
Yes, sir. Jesus Christ, I'm gonna die tonight.
You notice the large one says it says something, but you have no idea what. It's just. It could be just random noises that it's making, or it could be speaking to its smaller counterparts. You're not really sure.
Hopefully not casting a spell.
I'm going to dex save with that one, because he's kind of got to move through the grease. And passes. Alright. So now to make my charge attack. Hit. Seven damage on this guy. And... okay. Alright. Attacking Garrett Reeves.
You're all dead!
No, 13
doesn't hit.
No, 13 damage.
Oh!
Because it's critical.
I didn't realize that was the damage. Yeah, let's see. I'm at -8.
And what's your hit point maximum?
11.
Okay. So you're not dead, but now you have to start making saves.
Pretty close.
Alright. Got one more attack with this guy. That's a hit. A-stack takes some damage. Ah! And I don't have anybody else. Oh, actually, Dan's gonna get attacked again. And hit. 8 damage. Dan's hurting. Alright. Back up to the top. We got Bear.
I just yell ahead to, this is you call it a fae or a fairy?
Genasi.
Oh, that's what that is. Okay. Yeah. So can you grab the wounded and drag them back? I might be able to help them.
Don't do that. They'll attack of opportunity our unconscious asses.
And me. And then I'll go down.
Anyways. And then I'm just going to attack. I'm just going to attack this one.
Okay.
Okay.
12 is a miss. Seraphina.
I am going to produce flame and throw it at the grease.
Okay.
Over there. Like that shit on fire.
Can you link the spell card into chat for me? Like, do you have it on your spells list?
Let me see. How do I link it?
Do you have it on your spell list?
No, I just went to the SRD.
Oh, okay, I can just look it up then. The current flame appears in your hand, blah 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 blah. Yeah, so you just need to make a ranged spell attack against a AC of 5.
Okay. So it's, how do I roll spell again? It's
just roll a
d20. Do I use my spell attack bonus plus 5?
Yes.
Okay.
So you're basically rolling for 1, which you didn't.
Hooray!
You have successfully lit the grease on fire.
Yay!
And, cause it's grease, I'll have everybody around to take a little bit of damage. I'll have them take half. So they all take 2 damage from the... Because when the flame hits, it's gonna... You know what I mean? So, yeah. The big one and all the little ones around the grease took some damage.
Hiya!
Nice AoE.
Hiya.
Alright.
Fire and ice.
Chip, it's good that you're back, because you get to make a death saving throw.
Yay. What do I do?
Roll it right from your character sheet.
Oh. What?
Click the word that says death, for death saves.
Death save. It's right in the middle. That is a fail.
Why is that a fail?
Because 1 to 10 is a fail, and 11 to 20 is a pass.
Oh, that's some bullshit. So close.
This is 50-50.
So am I dead?
No. You just put a little check next to failures. So again, just to reiterate, the way that they do it in 5th edition is you get 3 chances, or, well, more, it depends on what you roll. But if you get to 3 failures, you die. If you get to 3 successes, you stabilize.
Okay.
And if you roll a 20, it counts as 2 passes. If you roll 1, it counts as 2 fails.
Got it.
Alright, Spruce Wayne.
I don't know if we should retreat or not. I'm going to delay to see what everyone else does.
Book says 10 is a success.
Yeah, I house ruled that.
Gotcha. Going back shutting up.
No, it's fine. That just didn't make any sense to me of like, why make it 48, 55%
chance. 52,
you know, yeah.
Gotcha.
So, that was Spruce Wayne. Woody?
Sorry, I had to rep the nation. I'm gonna fire another arrow.
Can we get some Vape Nation in chat for Ewok, please? For repping the nation. Go green.
That's a hit. 5 damage.
On which one?
Same one I shot earlier, right there.
Okay. Noted. Good hit.
He's seriously still not dead?
I'd like to take my delay.
Go ahead.
Oh.
On a ray of frost. The same target.
Okay. Hit. Dead. And that was this one, correct? That Ewok was shooting at?
Yeah.
Okay. Good job. Alright. Now for
that
20.
Fucking teamwork!
Wait. I'm gonna death save.
Oh, yep. There he is.
Yay.
I rolled something.
Okay, back to being quiet.
And come on, don't play with me, roll 20. Here we go. Reinforcements arrive.
More? What the fuck?
Our side.
Our side.
Oh, okay.
And here we go.
Chip, did you link it to Ewok?
Ready, Buckle? You get 10 hit points back.
Calm down.
Ready, Chip?
Yes.
You get 17 hit points back.
Cool, I'm alive!
So you're both up and conscious, but prone. Alright. And what happens is, from the Ilmatari priestess tent, a very, very old woman and a very, very young woman come rushing out. And the older woman says to the younger woman, "Get the wounded up, or we'll lose it all! And by the glory of Ilmater," they fill you with tingly goodness.
Tingly.
Like Tucky's lady bits.
Oh my.
Exactly. And not to be outdone, This one is going to go running into this tent, well, towards the opening of the tent. Let's see. Gang up. All right, Giggles, what the fuck is going on?
Everyone?
I didn't link it to everyone. You want to put it in chat?
Jesus Christ.
Oh my god.
I can't watch this while I'm streaming.
Oh, it's not. Well, maybe. I don't know.
All right. Now, I need everybody to make a wisdom save.
Oh god. Okay.
Oh shit.
Okay, Buckle and Ewok, you have disadvantage on attack rolls. As the large one moves into the camp and bellows, like, super loudly, it's just like, you know, it's like fucking Gabriel's trumpet, just, whoa, like, shakes the fucking walls of the whole camp.
Cool. What did you say we have? Minus two to what?
Advantage and disadvantage
on attack rolls.
Interesting that wisdom was the save. Neat.
It's closest to, like, a will save. All right, now I get to make some attacks. Oh, that should be an advantage. So that's a hit. That's a hit. Two on him. Definitely a hit. And a miss. So let me do that damage first. Eleven damage on Diane. And I'll just roll it all together for the other guy. 15 on him. Thank you, Anonymous, for that $5 holla. Thanks for the stream. Hey, thanks for being here, whoever you are. I appreciate that support, man. That's huge for me. Especially because I just got back from PAX and I'm doing like the shit, I gotta fucking pay rent next week. So that and bills and all that kind of shit. So thank you very, very much. That's very, very helpful. And I'm going to do one attack on a prone Garrett Reeves. And hit.
Oh. I haven't seen that emote before.
6 damage. Oh yeah, Buckle's got an emote now.
Sweet.
And since I have a surprise in store for this guy.
No.
It's a good surprise.
No.
I'm gonna roll with advantage.
You say that, but you don't really mean it.
And that's plus 8, so that's a hit. Please hold. I forgot I was gonna write this down, but I've got the page bookmarked. Why isn't it listed under that? Weird. Sorry guys, just give me a quick second. I know roughly where it is in the book. I just gotta find it. Good old Dungeon Master's Guide. Always here when you don't want to find something. Okay, there we go.
Apparently there's a planned mission to Mars in 2018.
Yeah, it's been around for a while. They've been taking candidates to test, like, they're not astronauts.
It's by SpaceX.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so you see this one run up to the front of this tent, and as soon as it opens the tent, you hear BANG! And a bright flash from the inside of the tent.
Is that where Rufus was hanging out?
What's that?
Nothing. Do your thing, sorry.
No, it's fine. And the thing, like, kind of staggers backwards, fucking seeping blood from a bunch of wounds in its face and neck.
Like a gunshot?
And does anybody speak Dwarvish?
No. Common Primordial Goblin Abyss.
Okay. Well, you hear somebody yelling in Dwarvish from inside the tent. A woman's voice.
Oh.
Alright, so back up to the top. Bear.
Is it from this tent?
Yep. So okay. Basically the thing, like, ripped the tent open, and as soon as the tent ripped open, you just hear BANG!
Yeah, fucking... Yeah, crazy. I'm actually gonna move back. Because I'm just thinking, this goes south, I'm on my own. That's my mindset right now. I'll move back. Can I move back, full movement intact?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, and I'm going to attack at the... where that tent was here.
Same one? Okay.
Yeah, the guy on the left, this guy.
Twenty-two is a hit. Roll damage.
Okay.
Nice. So you, like, hit it, like this bang happens, it staggers backwards, you run back and just catch it, like, right in the back of the head, and it does, like, the cave troll thing, like, in Lord of the Rings, where it's like, and then falls over.
Is it... did I kill it?
Oh, he dead.
Oh, nice. Okay. Sweet.
Good job. Keeping them from spreading throughout the camp. Alright, Serafina, you're next.
I'm gonna Sacred Flame that guy again.
Okay.
So, Dex.
Fail.
7.
7 damage hurt. Chip.
Hi.
Hey.
I want to do too many things.
Standing up costs half your movement.
Does it really?
It does.
Okay. Can I just do like a backwards roll over here and then stand up?
It's still gonna cost the same.
I know. I just want... just let me backwards roll. God.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Is that it?
That's it.
Alright. Bruce Wayne?
I'm going to Ray of Frost. This one.
Okay.
Two
damage heard.
Oh, my camera's been covered this whole time.
Oh, that's weird.
Oops.
Sorry about that, guys. I did not even notice. Let me fix that.
Censoring.
Your camera must have, like... it must have happened when your camera went away and then came back huge.
Oops.
Because then it'll just grab, like, the next window, which in this case was the VC window.
It's been... sorry, like, about that. For... like half an hour.
I didn't even notice. Because I had something else covering up my screen. I got a bunch of things open, so if you guys notice stuff like that, just let me know. So let's see. Woody is next. Woodette, sorry. Nice pen.
I am going to move back half my movement speed, then fire at this one.
Okay.
Disadvantage, right?
Why?
Oh, because of the bellow.
Because of the bellow. Nice, dude. Take 22. Experience.
Yep. Oh. Sweet. All right. Damage. 7.
7 hurt. And Garrett Reeves.
I'm going to stand up.
Standing up.
I'm going to smash this one right in the face.
Okay.
Right in front of me. At disadvantage. Is that 15 hit it?
15 does hit.
Okay. I'm going to whack her with the Warhammer.
Nice. You're wielding one-handed or two-handed?
One-handed. So I got my shield.
So it's the first one, right?
I assume the 7 goes to the 15, the 10 goes to the 19.
No, it's... The reason why they split it up like that is because you have a versatile weapon, so it does more damage if you're wielding a two-hand.
Yep.
So if you have a shield, it'll be the D8 plus 2 as opposed to the D10 plus 2.
Correct. Yeah, I've got my thing listed as D8 anyway. All right, since that connected, I would like to shield bash it back as a bonus action.
Awesome.
So that's going to be my athletics.
Opposed to athletics?
You get to use athletics or acrobatics, whichever one's better.
Athletics, yeah.
Is this also at a disadvantage?
No, because it's not technically an attack.
Cool. Oh, actually, with disadvantage, with this guy next to me... All right, never mind.
It would balance out, so I'd say so, just normal roll.
Okay. And oh, just in general, for as long as I got someone fighting with me, can I negate my disadvantage?
Oh, you got him.
Okay, so he shoved back 5 feet, and I'd like to take an attack of opportunity.
Yeah. I'll allow it, and I'll give you advantage because you're knocking him prone because he rolled a 1.
Cool. This guy also gets the swing out of 2 then, I think.
Yep.
Well, it's only 3 damage, but screw it. I'm just going to fucking shield bash and mace everything. Easy.
Dead.
I did something.
You guys just tag team the fuck out of that guy and just brought him all the way down.
Check ass.
Good job. That was heroic as fuck.
Spraying my feet.
Like, as you're doing this, like, you kind of glance over at him and he's bloody as fuck. Like, he's been bit several times, clawed several times. You can see blood just, like, pouring out of his armor. Like, he's barely standing up at this point.
I'm going to scream for Seraphina to get up here. I don't know if she's gonna listen or not. It'll be a polite request. Ship's healer. I don't have time to respond to you. I'm fighting for my life.
All right.
I'm just calling for you.
So first things first, gonna roll with haystack.
What do you want?
And hit. And Mr. Red Dot is dead. Dan is going to attack the one in front of him. That's not good.
Oh, man.
The higher the roll, the worse it is. When I roll a 96, Jesus. Buckle, pick high or low.
High.
Uh-oh.
Dang.
Oh my fuck. I told you he was hurt.
Is someone about to implode?
Ship's cleric?
This is me, Benzai. It's the other dude.
So basically what happens is Dan goes to strike at the one in front of him, like, way over swings, almost hits you, Buckle, but instead of hitting you, falls, like, on his side, so he just falls prone.
Uh-oh.
And he's gonna take a couple free attacks.
I just imagine he's going down, and these things are pouncing on him, and their, like, tails are all up, raptor style, as they're ripping into him.
And hit.
I see one. Get him!
Oh yeah, he's done. Basically, like, one grabs his bottom half, and the other grabs his top half, and they just tear him in half. As he's screaming, "Oh God!"
Sorry.
Ship's clever. Does Buckle get sprayed with all the blood?
Oh, yeah, I think so.
Oh yeah.
Maybe it'll work like walkers, and they'll ignore you now.
It's people blood on me, not walker blood.
R.I.P. Dan. We've lost our first NPC. All right.
I thought we already lost an NPC. The one that got guards.
This is a named NPC.
Yeah.
Not guard number 7.
Exactly.
This is an extra.
All right. And that was their reaction. So.
I'm not a fan of this.
Moving. And... Buckle, you gain another 12. Thanks to the young lady who is stalwart standing behind you.
I like having a pocket healer.
For them, it's not so much bravery standing in the face of certain doom as just this is what they do as Ilmatari. Like, they're selfless to a point of... It's better I should try and heal somebody and die serving my god than to not. And I need to make a save. Big guy. He fails and is held in place. Thank you, Griselda. The older woman. You can thank her for that later.
Are you making holes in my shirt?
Yeah. You didn't want holes in your shirt?
Yeah, sure.
It's all the style.
Yeah.
Alright, so real quick before we continue, because we're like way past where we usually take a break, is it okay with you guys if we take one? Because I really gotta pee and I can't think.
Let's do it.
All right. So we are going to take about a quick 5-minute break. Don't go anywhere, guys. We will be right back and figure out if you guys are going to live or not, because I'm really not sure. So we will be right back.
Okay. Go over here.
Aw, kitty. Did I lose Buckle?
Buckle loves me.
Back.
There he is.
I only saw Trip.
I'm in your head, Buckle.
That actually pretty entertaining.
I'm here. Yep.
Yeah, me too.
You don't want to be in his head. It's a scary place.
Yeah, Buckle's
a great place.
Alright, we are back. Cut the music. Unmute the people.
And put on the death metal, because we're about to die!
Nah.
Getting eaten alive by fucking lizard man. Didn't brush my teeth because I'm a fucking rebel.
Ew.
It's my metal song. Do you guys like
always
it?
Always brush your teeth.
Early, have you actually brush your teeth, though?
Yeah, really, though. Brush your teeth.
Let's hear from
nobody
the
likes
emo
to talk
goldfish.
To fucking mossy chompers.
I brush my teeth every morning and every night. Whiskey.
She's not kidding.
I don't know why. I totally expected Ewok to, like, have a goldfish and, like, hold it up when he said that.
What?
No, I was just going to do emo goldfish. That was pretty metal talk.
What the fuck?
So Ewok been listening to some, what is that, from Smodcast, or is that Edumacation?
That's Edumacation.
Yeah. So funny, though. Like, he just goes on and on and on with it, which is, like, the most hilarious part. Anyway, back to the action. So whose turn was it?
Well, who went last? That'd be a good way to figure it out.
Well, I think I was in the process of going. Yeah.
I think that guy got eaten.
He did, but that's why I wanted to pause, because I wanted to flavor text it for you. So, that guy gets ripped in half by these two lizard folk, crocodile folk. You're not really sure what to call them yet. In fact, if you guys can think of a good name for them, maybe that will happen.
Or crocobillies?
Trandoshans?
Terry floofs.
Do they look like they like
Fly
cousins?
Floofs. Bitey floofs.
So anyway, so these two rip him in half, and then the big one just steps in and, like, just swats them out of the way, and just one with each hand just... And away he goes. Down the gullet of the mighty beast. But promptly one turns its attention to Griselda. And that is a miss. Who looks yummier? Is it Chip? Or is it Seraphina?
Chocolate Chip?
Seraphina's on fire. That doesn't look edible.
Well, maybe if you, it's like one of those shots where you just blow on it and then you take it.
Chocolate Chip?
Of course she'd relate it to
I'm
alcohol.
Just waiting
she'd
for
be
the
like
day
a creme brulee.
An analogy that has nothing to do with alcohol.
I'm kind of concerned now.
Like, rappers rap about what they know, and Scruffles roleplays about what she knows.
And I make comments about...
Hey, Chip's not an alcoholic. Alcoholic. He's not an alcoholic.
I'm not drunk.
It's not my fault.
He is drunk.
You don't even had anything to drink.
Maybe that's...
She's not an alcoholic. She could stop whenever she wants.
Scruffles has too much blood in her alcohol stream.
I need to go get my coffee.
You need a moment before.
Well, I'll
what
wait.
Next happens?
I'll wait.
Because okay, you're getting
wait.
Attacked.
Oh, good. Well, what?
She
I thought
is
there was
fire.
An actual choice here.
Is it because I said chocolate chip?
But also,
she smells
that.
Like brimstone.
Biting at you and hitting you, right? Yeah, huh? That's it.
Yeah.
For 9.
0. Oh, can I take that failure off? Yeah?
Yeah? Yes.
Okay. So I'm back down to 0. This is stupid. I just want to punch people.
I know. Mm-hmm. But you're still low level. For now. It gets better. Alright.
Yeah, I'm gonna grab my coffee now.
I'm just trying to make sure that I didn't forget to move any of my tokens or do anything else. I think I still have to attack with Haystack, yes. Natural armor takes a damage. He chops a few scales off. So, back up to Bear.
And more attacks. I'm gonna start aiming at the big guy.
Okay.
This attacking is pretty nice.
I'll give you advantage because it's literally just standing there eating what's left of Dan. And I know that's weird for you, for me to say, but... This is an odd conversation to have with you. That is definitely a hit. Nice hit. You sink an arrow into its chest, but... It doesn't seem to take much notice.
It just kind of looks down at it.
It's big. It's like 10 feet tall, so...
Yeah.
And... 10 feet tall, but like hunched over 10 feet tall. Like if it stood up to its full height, it'd probably be closer to like 12, 13 feet tall. And Seraphina, you are next.
Back. Alright, I'm gonna actually Sacred Flame this one. Right here.
Okay. You have disadvantage.
It's a dex save, not an attack roll.
That's right. I keep forgetting that, and the other one that... Like, the two that we keep... Radiant something, Radiant Bolt, I keep mixing those two up in my head.
Guiding Bolt, I think, is in my campaign.
Guiding Bolt. That's what I keep messing
DP.
With.
I can use that one, too, but that's not what I'm using right now.
I didn't know you had it.
That's a fail.
Five.
Okay. And Chip.
Wait, did you say my name?
Yes.
Ah! Death save thing?
Mm-hmm.
Woo! Yay!
Pass.
Death. I got one.
Bruce Wayne.
Can I do an intelligence check to see if we taking out the big guy will, like, the opposite of a morale boost to the...
Roll nature with disadvantage.
Okay.
Demoralize, I think is what you're going for there.
Yeah. Oh, I just rolled that one.
Okay. Yeah, you don't know.
Okay.
Not your area of expertise. You don't remember reading about anything like these.
I'm move back here and Ray of Frost the big one.
Okay.
If that's okay.
Hit.
One! And a speeder is deuced by...
You froze the arrow that was in its chest.
Wow. All
right. Who's next? Woody? Et?
All right. So I think this is... I'm not going to be able to combat this turn, but I'm going to have an arrow ready. I'm going to wrap the old sock around it. I don't know if I can do this all turn, but then I was going to put some oil that I have in my burglar's pack and dip it in the fire right beside me and... Like, I don't think I can do all that in this turn and fire it. But yeah, that's what I was going to do. And fire it at the big guy.
Let me think about what you'd able to be able to get done. I'll let you do all that, but you can't fire this turn. You'll have to wait.
Alright, I'm just going to, as soon as I get done doing that, just have it ready and aim it right at his fucking eyeball.
Okay. The big guy, I assume. Okay. Garrett Reeves.
I'm hoping that second burst is the same as the first here. I'm gonna smash this dude right in front of me.
Okay.
Presumably still at disadvantage.
Just, yeah, it's still at disadvantage because of the bellow. Yep.
Yikes.
Roll D100. Roll a dexterity save.
I'm going on the ground again.
Nope, you're good. You do not fall. Regular miss.
Hooray!
Because you're kind of packed in the middle of a group of people there, so, like, you probably would have fallen, but the priestess behind you, just her being there, you kind of, like, bounced off her. And
sure hope that was a young one.
Yes, as a matter of fact.
His Grandma Winter's ankle shatters as a big armor-plated man lands at the door.
Get out there! I again.
Am complete.
Awesome. Now, start with this guy up here. And you hear screams coming from this direction as people in their tents are now fully realizing what's happening and panicking.
Fodder!
Goes to the tent. Hit. Oh. Yeah, that hits natural armor. So, another bang from inside the tent. And the bullets kind of, well, I guess I gave it away now, but...
Bullets?
Explosive blast from there's inside the tent.
Guns
kind of knocked it to the side.
I'm so excited. That opens up so many possibilities.
Shut up, Trip. Why you gotta shit all over my surprises? Can
you
I have
spoiled
a surprise?
It.
Barely spoiled it. Alright, just shut up. Alright? You're killing
me. You spoiled
me.
It. Ruined it. Ruined it. Ruined it.
We'll get to it after combat, okay? I understand how excited you are, but please contain yourself until the end of combat. Good job.
What?
And now, can we get Trip, like, a timeout box or something that he just, like, puts on his head? Where he's like, Trip, no.
Like a cardboard box with his timeout.
Ammo, can you make that, please? Thank you. That'd be great.
Go to your puffs box. Oh. All right.
Or you could, like, knit him a hat. A hat that says timeout.
Maybe.
And it's reversible, so it says time in.
You're making this too complicated. Go to your timeout hat.
Miss. It. What's your AC, Buckle?
Is it the same?
17.
Okay, then that's a miss. But the priestess behind you done got hit.
I think it's a new box, by the way.
She screams as one of these crocodile men latches its mouth around her arm. And you can just, you know, it's just... You hear the bones snap. She shrieks.
Would Scruffles like to imitate the shriek?
Huh?
What? Oh. Ammo, you're such a dick.
Well, Scruffles, what would sound would you make if some crocodile creature just bit your fucking arm? Like,
no.
Pulverized style.
I'm not making the noise. What's wrong with you guys?
Make the noise.
I don't know. I refuse.
This is where Thog has, like, the Scruffle screech.
No, you don't have to
hand.
Do the noise. I'm just, like, what kind of noise would you make? Oh.
Oh.
The kind that leaves the call.
She's out!
I don't know if she did that on purpose or if
it
was...
on purpose. Because no. It's still either showing her as busy on the...
Good timing, VC.
We'll be right back.
Hi. She can only see me and Trip.
Oh!
We're in her head.
Give it a minute and see if she pops back in. Let's see if I can do this. Does this work?
Oh! Nice girl. There's a thug. Oh!
No!
No!
Okay.
No!
I didn't lose
now
anybody.
We're all back.
I still need ammo and Ewok. Like ammo! Yes. Ewok! Get in here!
I don't right see Scrubbles now yet.
She's yelling at you guys to get in the call.
She is.
Oh.
Oh, wait, it says it's calling her now.
Oh, it worked!
There you are.
Beautiful.
She was like, everyone, get
I
in
told
here!
You.
That was a good video that you showed me of Pax, though.
I love that video.
Yeah, if you can find it, link it to chat. It was a good video. Okay. If you guys have watched Fate Zero, it was basically like a meme thing, like an animated meme, basically, about Grim Guzzler patrons in Hearthstone. Which are literally the most annoying card ever.
Oh, that one where it's inside Alexander's reality marble?
Yeah.
And it's all the people charging on horseback and him. Yeah.
And now I've got two attacks on Skadoogan McGee over there.
I've watched it, that anime now, so it, I know the reference.
It's probably one of my top 5 or 10 anime.
Oof.
Like the whole Fate series.
Haystack goes down.
Uh-oh.
No, not Haystack. He was going to teach me how to fight. No.
Well, you better go save him.
I'm down too.
But you should get up so you can go save him.
Get knocked down.
Is Haystack, is that this guy? That pink?
Yes. The gentleman with the red cape.
Gotcha.
All right. So Bear is next.
Okay, I am going to...
Oh, and Buckle, you get another Bardic Inspiration.
Yes!
I'm thinking you're talking to me when you say
or
Bear.
You haven't spent yours yet?
I used it.
Oh, you used it?
Oh,
you
wait.
Get it back. No, you decided not to.
Correct, I didn't use it because that 15 ended up hitting. Hitting.
What is,
cool.
What is your character's name, Scrubs?
Chip.
Chip.
Or Dale Swales, as I've been introducing myself.
Dale Swales.
Dale Swales. I don't even know how I came up with that name.
I think the liquor was doing the thinking.
I wasn't even drinking that night.
How can you be sure?
I know when I drink. Thank you.
Might she doesn't
have
drink.
Not
stand
time.
Only on the days that end in Y.
Attacking the woman at the tent here.
Right on. Different verse, same as the first.
They keep going into that tent purposefully. Yes. They want the gun.
Big loud noise coming from it. I feel like it's a drunk.
Alright, Seraphina.
I don't want a drunk to have a
I'm
gun.
I'm gonna hit that one again.
It's okay. Scruffles.
I want it.
Assholes.
IRL Scruffles in-game.
No, I'm never gonna be able to drink again.
Pass.
It's a meme.
That's what I felt when you called me a
I
drunk one
I still take
night.
Half damage, I don't know.
One night!
1 second.
Is that an Irish coffee?
No. It has
it
peppermint
says...
mocha.
Target
must
succeed on a dexterity saving throw or take 1d8 radiant damage. The target gains no benefit from cover for this saving throw. Blah blah. It doesn't say anything about half.
Okay. Your microphone's kind of quiet, Emma. I don't know if you're able to turn it up or move it closer or something.
Scooch, Emma. Scooch.
Yeah, that's better. Thank you.
What if I put it right here?
That works.
I really need to buy a pop filter. I still haven't.
I really want to get a microphone so I can bring it close to the radio voice.
Okay.
You're not popping struggles, so don't worry.
Death save.
Sometimes I do, though.
I learned, dude.
Yeah, I like to.
And, like, blowing on it is an issue sometimes.
Why would you blow on your microphone?
I don't have mine directly in front of me. It's over to the side.
What was the final vote count? We have to know. You can go ahead and link it if you want. Chip. Bale Swales. That's it.
Don't touch Chip.
It's Bruce Wayne.
Can I time a magic missile to go at the same time Woodette loses the arrow so it looks awesome? So it looks like all these little magic missiles are going with the arrow?
Sure.
Style. I'll roll it now.
Okay. So, go ahead, guys. This is your next anyway.
Pew, 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 pew! At the big guy.
And Ewok, I'll give you advantage for the style points. So I'll give you advantage on your attack.
Sweet. Is it my turn?
Yep.
Alright, here we go. 16?
16's a hit.
7.
Nice. So
I don't know what fire damage does to it, I just thought it looked cool.
So that's 18 damage. So it gets hit with a flaming arrow that's like soaked in oil along with 3 magic missiles, and it's just like fucking Godzilla style, like
I look at him or her or them and like
alright. Big fucker will remember that. So that was you guys. Now it's Garrett Reeves' turn.
Which one of these bad boys is the one that sank its teeth into
the one directly to your left?
That one?
Mm-hmm.
Good. That one is sucking Warhammer. Disadvantage. I presumably a 13. I guess it'd be 1d6, huh?
What's that?
Even if I got a 6 on my roll, it still wouldn't hit, right? On a 13?
Correct.
Got it. I'm just gonna sit here and suck for another turn.
Yeah, sometimes you roll good, other times you don't roll good. And
yep.
This is one of them times.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, use all your shitty rolls for this campaign.
I will do helpful characters first. So the Commodore, surly as ever, walks up behind Kip, smacks him in the back of the head, and says, "Would you quit your fucking caterwauling and go get the fucking kid up?" He runs over to Chip.
"That's me. I'm the kid."
Says Charisma. Gain 11.
Stay him up. Chip wakes up and he's like, "These guys fucking hurt."
Griselda is going to rush over to Haystack.
Yay, save Haystack.
Taking one attack of opportunity. Which misses. Really? No quality options? Bummer, dude.
Ben's time just donated to me.
Oh, really?
Thank you. Yay. Yeah.
Good guy,
Ben. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Oh, for a mic?
I don't know. It
probably said, towards it.
What? Oh, hi. Oh.
I will be sending out your cute little kitty tomorrow.
Hey, Stacks, back up.
Hey, Stacks.
Yay.
And
hey, Stack makes me think of hash browns. Some cafes refer to their hash browns as haystacks.
Random. Did not know that.
It's a Midwest thing.
Random fact of the day.
Excellent.
You can read Russian, Buckle? Or did you Google Translate it?
Better Twitch TV has a built-in translator.
What? Yeah. Wait, I have Better Twitch TV, so what?
Turn it on, double-click phrase. It gets, like, a rough approximation of what they say.
Yeah. It's not...
Cool.
It's not always a literal translation. Or, you get what I mean. Yeah.
But he followed up with good red, so presumably he's talking about Ambo's hair.
I dye my hair. Thank you. Dye my hair blue.
Reddest hair at PAX East. PAX East red hair champion.
Let's
go blue.
I win.
Buckle, the young priestess next to you.
Mm-hmm.
Places her good hand on you and grants you a shield of Illmater's faith.
What are you kidding?
My good hand.
What?
This is my good hand.
So you get plus two to your AC.
Sweet.
Missing something.
As long as you maintain concentration.
Seen what?
Scary movie.
Oh, not in a really long time.
The guy with the, like, deformed little hand. He's like, grab my good hand. And the person just like, let's go off the ledge.
Scary movie too. Where he's like, he stirs the potatoes.
Ugh.
Here, let me mix those up for you.
And you got a couple dwarven blacksmiths gonna help you out, Chip.
Who blacksmiths?
I would want dwarven blacksmiths to help me out.
Oh, now I gotta listen to that song.
That is a miss. One is also a miss. But they're there. They are what they are. But they're gonna try and defend the camp now that they see the Commodore watching. And Oros is still doing whatever Oros does. You've probably gathered by now he's not quite the most lucid individual.
I like him.
And now for the bad guys. I'm gonna attack Seraphina because she keeps zapping me.
No! Go away!
Snap! He gets you.
I was glad these things don't have like a fucking head thrash thing like crocodiles do.
What's that? They might. Own.
Oh, never mind then.
Garrett, go ahead and take a free. Gonna go for it?
I'm gonna go for it.
Right.
What am I saving it for? Fucking my quinceañera. Yes!
You got it!
Whoa! I was a shit there!
Yay!
Like your quinceañera.
Yeah, it's my quinceañera.
Hey, Buckle, the 15-year-old Mexican girl.
I'm not gonna lie, I would be worried that you would be okay, but if you just fell backwards when that happened, I would probably never, ever stop laughing.
Wow.
Good catch, though. Pass that reflex save. Oh, and roll the same damage. Take 10.
Wait, what?
Because you rolled 10 for both types of damage. I'll give you 10 experience.
Fuck yeah.
I'll try and do cool little neat things like that where I see it.
Do I get a bonus action?
No.
Not on a reaction.
Okay, just making sure.
Unless otherwise specified, bonus actions only happen during your turn. Reaction is the only thing you can do on another turn. Again, unless otherwise specified. And going to be attacking a prone chip. And hit. Four damage, Chip.
No.
Swiped at your legs with its claws.
Don't do that.
Stop.
Stop it.
Hurts. Oh boy. Yeah. Yeah, I think now's about that time. Oh, nailed it. This thing leaps entirely over this group. And lands
here. Oh my god.
Now.
Please.
We got us a good old fashioned choice of target situation here, boys and girls.
No.
Alright, Trip, pick evens or odds.
Evens.
Sorry, Ewok. Swiping at you. At least it's the claw.
Ooh, the claw.
The claw.
Nothing can stop the claw.
Oh, well, we saw Toy Story 3 for the first time, that was so fun.
Standard critical.
Oh. What, Trip?
When we saw Toy Story 3 for the first time and they were like all about to die, and I'm like, I looked at her and I went, the claw. And then 2 seconds later, the claw.
9 damage.
I am down.
Yeah, so it just swipes you and you just fucking drop. Just ruin that perfectly good figure.
At least I don't have silicone.
That's true. You don't have to worry about getting poisoned.
His tit popped!
Alright. And back to Bear.
Oh, Benzyme wishes to activate the Sandwich King.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, boy.
I've been waiting for one of these.
I'm scared. I'm scared.
Let's see what I gotta roll for this.
Oh no.
I did write tables down. One of these. There we go.
Is this a subscriber thing? Or what is this?
Yeah, every month he has like a little maze map and people can find like cards and the cards have uses.
I want to know what the next one is. Because they've got Trip the Sandwich King and what was the Scruffles card call again?
I know exactly something what about. We'll do. Everybody roll d10.
Canada.
Even me?
Yep, everybody.
I win!
Alright. I know exactly what that's going to be. Because it's, basically what he did is he activated a random encounter. But that might not necessarily be a bad thing. I just have to see on the table exactly what it is.
Are we about to get a good old Japanese fucking kaiju movie?
Maybe.
A giant Sandwich King monster shows up and kills it. Its head is like the burger that you had in the face ring. And like it yells and like mustard comes and spittle.
There we go.
Not just that, but they're gonna be made of sharp cheese. Delicious.
Oh, that's fucking awesome. You've got to be kidding me. That's so perfect. Please tell me Lepa is here. Is Lepa here?
Was.
Lepa's just about to shit himself.
Oh, God.
No, this is something he's been asking to see in our games for a long time.
Oh.
This is going to be cool.
I'm scared.
All right, I got to find a token, so just give me a moment, guys.
He's here. Lepa's here.
Awesome, Lepa. You are in for a treat, sir.
I don't know if I should be concerned.
You will miss. And also, Orgy, or Orgy, however you pronounce it, and Kel, thank you all for those follows. And anybody else I might have missed while.
Scared.
Have a token I don't own. I'll improvise. And Clown Sickness, thank you very much. I appreciate the follow love tonight, guys. Very awesome. What would be the next closest thing? I guess this will work. But which to you?
Oh, this is really funny because they got me a sandwich for dinner.
Yeah, this one will work.
I haven't had a sandwich in a long time.
All right.
So
I'm just dragging the token out onto the screen. This doesn't signify the size. Need to adjust that.
So is it giant? Or... I'm scared.
Nope. It's little.
I'm scared. Adorable.
What is it?
You're about to find out.
I don't think it's friendly.
Usually things that look cute aren't.
Like the Holy Grail rabbit.
Sharp fangs.
It's good. And
you see. Appears to be a cat-sized dragon with butterfly wings.
Huh.
It wears a sharp-toothed grin and expresses its delight by twitching of its tail, which it is very, very happy right now. It gets to make a new friend. This big, nasty, scary lizard folk crocodile guy. So this is gonna be fun.
The blue babies in Galaxy Quest. Oh god.
I like how terrified Emma. Oh, Lepa. Lepa knows what it is.
I'm not happy about how happy Lepa is.
When Lepa's happy, that means I shouldn't be happy.
Emma, roll d20.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
It's a good thing. It's a violet color. So.
Pretty.
Very. So fucking awesome.
God damn it, don't stab it.
So it flies in front of this giant lizard folk thing, and as it passes in front of its face, it just goes and a little puff of gas shoots out and into the thing's face, and it just kind of stumbles backwards.
I don't
and
know what's
to be that. Very confused.
What's going on?
I think I got hit with that gas.
Yeah.
Because I'm confused.
Hey, actually, dude, thank Benzyme and the party because he played the card that made it happen, and then the party rolled to randomly determine it, so. Because I had a little table of, like, the random encounters that could encounter, that you guys could find while wandering, so. This was one of them.
Damn.
So wait, our cards do stuff?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
So what exactly... So my card was a random encounter?
Yeah.
Who found mine again? Didn't Lepa find both of them?
Your sandwiches attract things.
Well, then what does mine do?
Don't ask.
We have to find out.
You have to find out. I can't tell you. Only the person who has the card knows what it does.
It's gonna be something stupid.
Which in this case is Loki.
Loki, what does my card do? Is he? He's not even here.
God. I don't think he's here. So that's awesome. That might have actually just saved your asses. So. Yeah, I don't even know what initiative we were on when we did that. I think we're back up to the top. So.
Yeah, I think you were rolled.
Alright, so I'll do helpful characters first.
Yeah, you had just done the attack on Buckle, I think.
Attack
Serafina,
on Buckle.
You heal for 11, thanks to the bard behind you.
It's a new anime, Attack on Buckle.
I'd watch it.
Attack on Buckle. Da, 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 da,
it's all of your
da,
beer
da,
bottles
da.
Coming to life
Buckle,
and eating you.
That would be terrifying.
He's concentrating.
Got like
on
200
doors.
Points there.
Have fun with that nightmare.
Bang! From inside the tent.
This thing's gonna eat Buckle.
And takes his fucking head off!
I like whoever's in the tent.
Yeah, you hear.
Me too.
A woman's voice yelling in Dwarven. Obviously very excited.
Okay. It's got a pretty good reload speed.
And...
Or it's revolver.
Schmucky McGee up here... pulls a civilian out of a tent and starts eating them.
Oh, cool. It's not gross at all.
Lovely.
I mean... We'll make more.
We'll make more?
Well, yeah, you a trip.
Emma's like, wait, what am I signing up for here?
To be an NPC factory.
Yeah.
I meant the camp.
Mm-hmm.